No, this can't be happening. Chad is not breaking up with me. Not in the middle of my apartment hallway. And not after spending 3 hours in my bed.
Look, I don't want you to take this personally. I just don't think our lifestyles are compatible. I mean, it's clear you don't really take care of yourself.
I don't respond. I'm speechless. Stunned.
For instance, I love to exercise, and you?
He gestures at my body. My curvy, luscious body that I've always loved. It's as if he's saying, clearly, you don't care how you look.
I pride myself on eating clean.
He chuckles and shakes his head.
And let's face it, I've seen the inside of your pantry. I mean, you could feed a village with all that chocolate.
I still can't get my mouth to form words, so I just stand there, mouthing like a fish.
You understand, don't you? It just wouldn't make sense between us.
He gives me a smile filled with pity.
This was fun, but in terms of a relationship, we should both box in our own weight class. Don't you think?
I don't know what to think. My self-esteem just took such a dive. I'm worried I'll get a nosebleed. He takes a step toward me.
I don't want to leave on bad terms. Say something, Lulu Bell.
I cringe at the nickname, and I'm just about to respond when the door across from mine opens. It's my new neighbor, Shane. And by the look on his face, I can tell he heard everything. Well, isn't that just the icing on the cake? Embarrassing myself in front of someone like him. Shane is handsome enough to be famous, with a body that looks like it's been carved from stone. I bet he's never been dumped before, let alone for his weight. I feel tears forming, and I'd rather die than have either of them see me cry, so I run back inside my apartment, slamming the door in both of their faces. The next morning, I put on a pair of neglected running shoes at 6 a.m., ready to follow a plan. Because last night when I looked in the mirror, for the first time, I didn't like what was staring back. So, I'm gonna fix it. I'll exercise every morning, cut out all sweets and carbs, lose 20 pounds, and then throw my new body in Chad's face. All this sounds great in my head, but when I walk outside, my confidence falters. It's the middle of July, and even at 6 a.m., it's balmy. It also registers that I have no idea what I'm doing. I half-ass some stretches, and then make my way to the sidewalk. It's quiet. No one else is around. Thank God. I force myself to start running. It's not as bad as I thought it'd be. I make it to the end of the block without breaking a sweat. But by the next block, sweat is forming in some really uncomfortable places. And by the next one, I'm on my hands and knees, gasping for air. How far did I go? A mile, at least? I look back and my stomach falls. I can still see my apartment building, after only a quarter of a mile. I can barely catch my breath. Running isn't for people like me. It's for skinny people. And that's something I've never been. Shame and self-pity war within me, and both have me turning for home. Now, on top of everything else, I'm a quitter. Later that night, I get home around 8 p.m. I had a long day at work, and I'm starving. All I want is pizza, but I force myself to take home a salad instead. Needless to say, I'm not looking forward to eating it. I'm so miserable. But then I notice a package in front of my door. I recognize the box instantly. Sandy Sweets, home to the best cupcakes in the county. What is this doing here? Before I can read the tag, the door across from mine opens again. Shane. He's in a tank and athletic shorts. And as usual, his body looks as hard as a Roman statue. His eyes flick to the box, then back up to me.
I heard good things about that place, so I swung by after work.
I freeze in place. Oh my God. He got me cupcakes?
Figured you might need a little pick-me-up.
He clears his throat.
You know, after yesterday. That guy was...
His face turns hard.
Anyway, there's nothing wrong with sweets. You shouldn't take his words to heart.
I stare at him in shock. And the humiliation from last night rushes to the surface. Any other time, I'd be flattered by the gesture. But not today. Not after last night. Oh, I see. Get the fat girl cupcakes. That was your big idea? He physically recoils at my words.
Wait, what?
You just assume that food is gonna make me feel better? That I just spend every night stuffing my face? You know nothing about me. He looks utterly shell-shocked.
Jesus, no! I was just...
But I don't let him finish. Instead, I run inside my apartment, just like I did the night before.